right, everybody. Thanks for coming back and visiting us at the Range Report. And if you've been paying attention to the Second Amendment community and everything that's happening in the last year and a half, you know the gentleman standing to my side here. This is Mark Robinson, candidate for Lieutenant Governor in North Carolina. Mark, thank you so very much for coming and meeting us. And we're here at the Moore County Wildlife Club. And Mark's here tonight to talk to some of the members about his candidacy for his campaign and his stances on the Second Amendment. So I figured we'd get you on camera and press you a little bit about some of the happenings going on today with the Second Amendment. So overall, what do you feel the Second Amendment, why do you feel the Second Amendment is as important as it is? For those who have not seen your extremely viral video that was out about a year ago.
Well, for me, it just goes back to, you know, that old saying about the proof being in the pudding. If you look throughout history, every nation that's ever allowed its citizens to be disarmed, every one of them in the 20th century have always ended up in peril. All the way back to the Soviet Union, you go back to them when they disarmed their citizens. You had this massive amounts of starvation, mass murder. Nazi Germany, we saw the same thing. We saw the same thing after World War II in China. We saw it in Cuba. We saw it in Cambodia. And now we're seeing the same thing today in Venezuela. So anytime a citizenry allows itself to be disarmed and have their God-given right to self-defense taken away, it never ends up good. Those nations always end up with despotic governments. We can't allow that to happen in this country.
It is kind of shocking to see, half of our elected officials today seem to be on hell-bent on that course.
Absolutely.
And a good portion of the ones that we always thought were on our side are also leaning in a direction with these red flag laws.
Absolutely.
And they don't seem to understand the dangers that are involved with that.
Absolutely. You know, I describe our Constitution as a fortress. It's a fortress, and anybody knows when you have a fortress, you have to have firepower in that fortress. Our Second Amendment is the firepower in the fortress of our freedom, which is our Constitution, and that's why it's so vital to hold on to it. When it comes to these red flag laws, what's dangerous about that is we see how people abuse the law now. You take, for example, these orders of protections that people use. People use those for a myriad of things. We see people all the time getting kicked out of their own homes because of false restraining orders. We even saw with the Obama administration how they weaponized the IRS to use against its political enemies. So think about what would happen if they had a tool to use and could weaponize in these red flag laws against lawful gun owners. It's just not a good thing for us. It's not a good thing for the Constitution.
Yeah, they use these arbitrary terms about, you know, how they're going to identify somebody that's dangerous. Well, what is dangerous? Is somebody who just, you know, is mowing the lawn and gets mad at one of the neighborhood kids for throwing stuff on the lawn, or is it the guy who's actually potentially violent? We don't know who's going to be making those judgments, so how can we just put blankets across everybody to take everyone's rights away from
them? And then it goes to the question, who do you get? Do we get the same people who allowed a man in Texas who was a triple murderer on death row, who eventually got off death row and then eventually got paroled from prison and then went on after he got out of prison to murder 9 more women? Are those the kind of people we're going to have administering red flag laws? People who can't even punish criminals who have been properly adjudicated and put into prison? We're going to have those type of people administering red flag laws and making those judgments? I think not. Mm-hmm. And in a lot of cases, you would have people who would make erroneous judgments and be taking away people's constitutional rights without due process. And again, that is the danger of red flag laws.
You know, that's just one of. People don't realize that it's such a domino effect. That,
absolutely.
You know, after they leave with your guns, Child Protective Services is at your door to come and take your kids.
Your kids, right.
You know, and they also don't understand the fact that being that it's a civil mm-hmm. matter, because you have not been charged with a crime, that mm-hmm. when you have to go get an attorney to get your guns back, mm-hmm. that's out of your pocket.
They're not
going to appoint a lawyer to represent you if you had been charged with a crime.
That's exactly right. So, we're talking about creating millions of scenarios for possible violations of people's constitutional rights and actually putting people in peril. I mean, you think about this example. Think about the woman who's armed against her abusive husband, and her abusive husband goes down and makes a false charge against her saying she's threatening. The government comes in, takes away her gun. Now she's wide open for this abusive person to come back and harm her. What do we do for her? Yeah. You know, there's too many scenarios that red flag laws create. Too much danger to people's physical safety and too much danger to our constitutional rights. And they're just a bad idea all the way around.
And then you have another example is the married couple.
Yes.
You know, they take one person's gun from them, but if the stuff is the spouse's,
absolutely.
Now they're going to have to take the spouse.
Exactly.
Now you've taken the liberty away from two individuals.
That's exactly right.
And an entire family just to try and placate this political correctness.
And these conundrums with red flag laws just go on and on and on and on, which is why, again, they're so dangerous and they're not a good ideal and should never be implemented.
If only they made murder illegal.
Exactly. Exactly.
Then it would stop.
You exactly.
know, that would be the one law that we could have that would put an end to all
exactly.
of this.
Exactly.
But, Alyssa, now about your campaign.
Yes.
What prompted you to run for lieutenant governor?
Well, I'll tell you, some people came to us wanting to run for a couple of the offices, but we chose lieutenant governor because we felt like lieutenant governor would be a big enough position to give us an opportunity to push some of the agendas that we feel like need to be pushed. And we also feel like that this state definitely needs some strong conservative help with Dan Forrest running for governor. Leaving the job of lieutenant governor, we need somebody just as strong as his conservatism to move in right behind him. And so that's why we chose to run for this office. Plus, there's a lot of other reasons also. You know, one of the big reasons is because I want people to understand that, you know, it's not just the Harvard and Yale crowd that can run for office. It's the regular, common, average, everyday folks. And that's what the founders intended.
Right.
One of the worst things about our society right now is that we've allowed our politicians to become another ruling class. And they were never intended to be that. They were intended to go to Washington, go to Raleigh, go to the State House and serve for a little while and come home. Instead, we have these career politicians that are using these positions not to serve the people, but to serve their own power and positions. And that's not the way it's supposed to be. So. Mm-hmm.
Well, I gotta tell you, it's very seldom that somebody rises to the level of prominence in the public eye, mm-hmm. and instead of using that position to enrich themselves, they use that position to further the freedoms of the American people.
That's
and because you've
yes.
decided to do that, mm-hmm. not only for myself, but everybody watching and the rest of the Americans, I have to say thank you.
Thank
God
you.
Bless you. And
yes,
you have our support 100%. Any of you that are in North Carolina, when it's time to pull that lever, this is the man you got to be pulling it for, because he's pulling for you.
Thank you very much.
Well,
go to markrobinsonfornc.com to visit my website.
There you go. Absolutely.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much, sir.
Thank you. All right.
Well, I think it's time we ask ourselves if we still know the freedoms that were intended for us by the founding fathers.
Oath and rights, when politicians take from you and me the very liberties that set us free. Open fight for this democracy is you and me. We're the refounders, saddled up, let's ride. Now will the real Americans please stand up? No more hiding your face in the sand. Will the real Americans